Exclusive interviews with artists from around the globe. Hooking you up with those fresh hits first. Without further ado, this is the exclusives on Mix Radio. Tonight on Exclusives on Mix Radio, my special guest is a native Angelina who creates soulful music. You may have seen her at local LA venues such as Hotel Cafe and previously at the House of Blues. She's also best known for her role on Freedom's hit series The Fosters, Awesome TV Side Effects, NBC's Chicago PD, and currently as Cindy on CW and DC's Universe series Stargirl. Singer, songwriter, and actress Meg DeLacy is in the house. Welcome to Exclusives on Mix Radio.
Thank you so much for having me.
How has quarantine life been treating you? What have you been doing?
I've been taking a lot of walks around my neighborhood. I just moved to a new place, so that was actually pretty exciting to kind of get a vibe of where I'm living now and also manageable in this quarantine. I've just been hanging out with my little kitty and, painting a little bit. I've been marinating olives. I've been...
Nice.
Just finding little activities to kind of keep me busy, and then watching television. I don't really watch trash TV, but I kind of got into it for the past couple of months. That's been kind of interesting. just keeping it chill and making sure just to keep in contact with friends and family as much as I can since I can't see them.
Now, has the quarantine affected work, with acting and doing things like that?
Oh, yeah, it has. I mean, production has completely shut down. They just opened a few days ago. But self-tapes are kind of a thing, but a lot of the casting directors don't know exactly when things are going to be shooting again. So it's like a feel out.
Wow.
But everything's been good. I mean, I'm doing a virtual play right now. Are you familiar with virtual plays? I know it's kind of like a weird term.
Everything is virtual nowadays, so I wouldn't be surprised if
exactly.
That's a thing.
Right. So I'm doing a virtual play right now, and we are exploring the space between film and theater via virtual, like Zoom classes and everything. So my character is someone who is just going through the trials and tribulations of being a freshman in college. I'm playing a freshman in college during quarantine. And so I had to kind of dive into, what schooling is like online. My sister ended her whole senior year online. So hearing her experience was a little jarring, but also like, I guess we have to find a way to make it work and still become educated and all that stuff. So that's been kind of interesting, acting wise. Music wise, I had a little show. Hotel Cafe had a uncanceled show at the beginning of quarantine, which was really cool to participate in. I played with my brother and we played guitar and he played some bass. And just trying to find inspiration as much as you can, which it hasn't been too difficult. But if you tell yourself, oh man, I'm losing it, I can't handle this, it's when you kind of fall into a rabbit hole. So it's been just trying to keep out of that.
Yeah. So now that quarantine's lifting a little bit, especially in LA, what is the first place that you are going to go and visit?
I've been wanting to go. I mean, this is Los Angeles, but it actually kind of ties into the song. I've been wanting to go to Catalina Island for a while now, and I didn't even realize how much I really wanted to do it and go until this quarantine happened. So that'd be kind of sick to go to Catalina. I feel like you'd be kind of away. You feel sort of away from everything.
Yeah.
Other than that, just like finding, just going to my restaurants again and dining in and going maybe to like a bar or like sitting down and talking to someone face to face at a table. That's what I miss. Honestly, it's the simple little things.
What's your favorite spot in LA?
I love Thai food. So there's this spot in Hollywood called Toi, T-O-I. And their ambiance is so crazy. It's like you're walking into kind of like a rock and roll, kind of dim lit, all moody. And then they have this table on the floor where you can eat on the ground. And I know they probably won't have that when we go back just because of whatever reason. Hopefully they do. I don't know. It's kind of a cool experience. And they have just art everywhere and it smells delicious. It's kind of like you're jumping into a little Thai town.
That sounds awesome. Well, we're excited to have you on the show. Excited to talk to you more about music. You got this brand new single that just came out today, and we're going to talk about that in a little bit. But I want to bring you back to one of the early songs that you had in your career. You put out a song called Red Wine. So let's talk about that for a little bit. How did that song come together?
Okay, so Red Wine, I wrote a long time ago. Even before, like, I released it, I think 2 years ago, but I wrote it like 2 years before that, or maybe like a year and a half before that. It was one of the first songs I wrote with a producer, and we found a sound that was pretty unique. And it was one of the first songs that kind of taught me slash showed me that I can write. Because it took me a long time to kind of branch out and kind of get out of this shy place of being vulnerable and putting down words that I actually believed in and wanted to sing and share. Red Wine was the beginning of that. And I was kind of playing with imagery of what love looked like and tasted like to me.
We know you from obviously your YouTube channel and of course, because of your roles in acting, but what got you into music?
So I started musical theater before I professionally started acting, before I ever started writing, before I even picked up the guitar. So singing was always in me. Growing up, my father isn't a musician, but he is very music inclined, and he would play the guitar. He kind of was like, yo, you should pick it up and see if you're good at it. And then my cousin ended up teaching me lessons because he was a musician. So it runs in my family in some sorts, but I think day one was probably my dad being like, I think you're good at this. I was always running around the house singing, you know, pretending like I was Ariel, you know, from The Little Mermaid.
Nice.
Just humming or just wanting to use my voice in some sort of way. I always felt like I was a performer, and that just became more clear once I got on the stage and started musical theater.
Now, if you had to choose between acting and doing music, you can only pick one. Which one do you think you'd do?
I get this question so much because you can't necessarily, if you're starting from the bottom and you're trying to lift off into your career, I think it's impossible to be able to do music and acting at the same time because it can't be 30-70. It can't be 50-50 even. It has to be 100%. So there's been years where like I haven't booked anything and I'm just in the studio writing constantly. And that was 2018 for me. My producer and I, his name is Jamie Silverstein, him and I, we hustled and we got a ton of songs in 2018. And I was just in the studio maybe three times a week, just trying to get content, just writing. We'll release it at one point, just write and get the kinks out and get the sound down. And then 2019, I booked Stargirl and that took me to Atlanta for 8 months. So I wasn't with my producer. I wasn't able to really like play my guitar that often. I wasn't writing as much as I could, but I was going full force in the show. So that was just kind of the example to me, like showing myself being like, oh, I have to be 100% in this. There's been times where I have roles where I can perform and sing and act at the same time, kind of what the Fosters did. My character fortunately also played the guitar and also sang. So that was really cool to kind of have both at play. But this is what I would say. I'd say I love acting and I love putting myself away and pretending to be other people. So I will live my life and make a living doing that, but I will always die making music because that is me, that is vulnerable, and that's
like your escape, right? That's a way for you to kind of get away from everything.
Exactly, right, correct.
All right, so a couple of years ago you wrote this song called Trapeze, and so what was the most memorable moment about creating this song?
So Trapeze is one of my only ballads. One of the only songs that are just strictly all piano, all raw instruments. And that song is a super vulnerable song to me because I wrote it during a time where I was going through something that felt like I couldn't see the other side of it. And it was something that I felt like I was going to have to deal with for the rest of my life, which it is. And I wrote half of the song when I was in a pretty, like, not such a good place.
Yeah.
And then I didn't finish it. And actually Lou was like, you need to finish this song. Like, this is a really good song. You need to finish it and we need to release it. And I'm like, I don't want to put myself back into that place because now I didn't finish it. Now a few months have gone by. It was one of the only songs that I've actually like stopped writing in the middle, which was trippy.
Yeah.
And I was like, I don't want to put myself back in that place because I feel like I'm healing, like I'm getting better. So then instead I approached the song once I did again and finished it. I tried to find the full circle and the epiphany in the song. So it was a transition. It was a journey. It was a journey track, honestly. And when I played that song live for the first time, like, I almost started to cry. It was like the first, I think one of the first times I've ever really kind of sort of got emotional on stage. I don't know if people saw it. I know some people did because they knew what the song was about and they were like, yo, I see you.
Yeah.
No, it's just a close to heart song, very personal, but the lyrics itself are broad enough for people to just listen and apply their own story to it, which is essentially why I wanted to release it and why I think it's such a true to heart song. My parents kind of get a little sad when they listen to it too, but it's not sad. Like, oh my God, so sad. It's just like, wow. Like I feel you. Like I hear you and I feel you. I feel you through these words.
Kids are saying today, get you all up in your feels, right?
Yeah. Yes, exactly.
Meg DeLacy is our special guest on Mixclusives and Mix Radio. And in your bio, you mention artists like Jean Aiko, Amy Winehouse, Kareem Bailey Ray, Santi Gold as your musical influences. What about these artists inspire you?
So Kareem Bailey Ray, Santi Gold, I love the raw instruments that Kareem uses. I love the bass beats that Santi Gold uses and the way that they kind of, they're just the production of their songs are so opposite, but combining them create like a really cool genre that I really wanted to emulate. Jhené Aiko and Amy Winehouse, their lyrics are what I really listen to when I listen to their songs. Yeah, that's something that I'm always thinking about. Lyrics are huge for me. I'm a huge lyric girl. Whenever I listen to a song, yes, I want to feel good, but I also want to, you know, be taken on a little journey.
So one thing I wanted to ask you is not too many people know that you're half Filipino. What would you say is your favorite Filipino food?
My favorite Filipino food, I will have to say, is probably pancit. I'm a noodle girl. Love noodles.
Nice.
Love them. Yeah. Pancit. And then the fresh egg rolls, I'm forgetting what they're called. So not lumpia is great.
Yeah.
But the fresh ones, do you know?
Oh, and then yeah, and they're freshly wrapped, and then you put that kind of gravy thing on top. Is that?
Yeah,
what
yeah, yeah. Yep. And also the peanut sauce. It comes with like the peanut sauce. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
I'm blanking on the name, but I remember having that. We had bogle fat. No. No. The long spread of food. And you have it on grape leaves or banana leaves, I'm sorry.
Oh.
Like a bogle fight. I think it's called bogle fight.
I know what you're talking about.
Anyway. Yeah, yeah. We had they served those there and it blew my mind. I forgot that I even tried one when I was little. It's like this whole nostalgic kind of thing that happened. But there's so many yummy foods. I actually just visited my grandmother today who was on my mom's side, who's Filipino.
Oh, they're saying it below.
We're talking about Filipino food. And
they're calling it boodle fight.
Boodle fight. There we go. Have you ever been to a boodle
fight? I've never been to a boodle fight.
You've never? It's usually just like a whole spread of food on this long ass table and you use your hands to do it. It sucks. Boodle fights probably will be, you know, whatever. You can do it with your family.
It's like Kamayan style, sort of.
Yes. Okay. Yes. Exactly. It's delicious. It's so much fun too. It's such a party.
All right. You got to make me a promise. When this whole quarantine thing lifts and we all get to go back to work in LA, you and I are going to one of these boodle.
Come wolves. Over. Yes.
All right.
Boodle fight.
There you go.
I'll throw one.
There you go. Even better. We'll bring Lou over and everything. We'll make it a boodle party.
Perfect.
All right. So Meg DeLacy's in the house. She has a brand new song. It is called Some and All of It. So tell everyone a little bit about this song.
So Some and All of It is literally, it's very fitting for this time. It's literally talking about an escape to an island and you getting island fever and actually enjoying it and not wanting to leave. It's all escapism. It's all just flowy hair, the beach. I shot the video at Catalina Island, so full circle. And just enjoying the freedom of being free.
We thought it would be fun to do a game with you. So I kind of looked through all your YouTube videos. And so the game that we're going to play is called Song Roulette. And so I got this little spin wheel thing. I'm going to press it. And then whatever song that comes up, you have to do a live version of that right now. And it doesn't have to be long. Just a quick snippet of the song.
Okay. Yeah, let's try it. Okay.
All right.
This is cool. This is fun.
You ready? Here we go. The first song is Just Friends by Music Soul Child.
Okay. Hold on. Oh my God. Wait, hold on. Da, 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 da. Oh, yeah. Da, 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 da. So how about this? Why don't you come out? Something, 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 and then that, and you can call me someday. Dun, dun, dun. Oh my god, it's been so long since I did this. Okay, wait. Let's get the chorus. Wait, the chorus is remind me what do you remember the chorus?
I'm drawing a blank right now too, as we're talking.
You digging me? You aren't digging me. Just friends, hang out and chill, something like that.
Come there you go.
Come see a movie, baby. We can just be friends, baby. Wow. That song. No. Let's do it again. Let's do another one.
Okay, here we go.
Another one. That was not an applause. That was horrible.
And I'm gonna tell you, there's a couple sleepers in this thing too. So just FYI.
Okay, I got you.
All right, the next one is Baby Shark.
Baby Shark?
Baby.
What's Baby Shark?
You don't know Baby Shark? Oh my gosh. Okay.
No.
I'm going to have to email you Baby Shark. I'm going to text it to you after this.
Oh my God.
Baby Shark. Do, 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 do. Baby. No?
Baby Shark. Do, do, do. Baby Shark. Do, 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 do. Baby, that's not it, but I'm just making it. I don't know what Baby Shark is.
Next one, here we go.
Okay.
I told you there were sleepers in this thing.
That's what you meant. I was like, what is he talking about?
Suit and Tie by Justin Timberlake.
Okay. Oh my God, these are like so long ago. I'm like, when did I even do this cover? Okay, Suit and Tie, that's... How does it even start? Wait, as long as I got my suit and tie. As long as I got my suit and tie, I'm gonna leave it on the floor tonight. And you got in that dress you like. Let me show you a few things. I'll just up in black and white. And you got in that dress you like. Love another thing, something tonight. Let me show you a few things.
There you go. You get that.
Oh my gosh. Wait, who helped me with that? Seriously, like, Christina Montanez, thank you. I forgot that was even the line, and that's literally the line of the song.
All right, we got two more. Okay. You ready? Here you go. Let's spin the wheel.
Okay. I'm so nervous. Oh my God.
So the next one is Any Song by Gene Iko.
Oh, okay. Oh, I'm trying to remember Bed Piece. Oh my God, how did it go? Okay, you know what? I'm just gonna do Party Hard. I know that just came out by her just a couple of days ago, and it goes like this. Party hard, party hard, party hard for me. Yeah. Party hard, party hard, party hard for me. Got the party on the beach. Everybody come through. Da-na-na-na-na, crap, I don't know the rest. Party hard, party hard, party hard for me when I'm gone. There we go.
That's the slap, though. That's her and Tyga on that song. So that's the joint.
Yes, it's so good. It is really good. That piece is really good, too. And I was, like, trying to, like, lift myself off into, like, the beginning of the song and, like, re-remember the beginning. Yeah. I
All right. Last one. No, you're good. Here we go. Last one.
Okay.
Your go-to song when you hit the shower.
Okay, what's my go-to song when I hit the shower? It would have to be an Amy Winehouse song.
Valerie? Can you do Valerie?
I can do Valerie. I mean, I could do Valerie. Yeah, I could do Valerie. Well, sometimes I go out by myself and I look across the water. And I think of all the things that you're doing, and in my head I paint a picture. Since I come home, well, my body's been a mess, and I miss your tender hair and the way you like to dress. Yeah, won't you come on over? Stop making a fool out of me. Why don't you come on over, Valerie?
Woo!
Woo!
Seem like breaking things already.
Thank you. I know. I'm happy that I pulled that one out of my pocket. I wasn't sure. Because everything just forget everything while I'm interviewing.
I have that effect on people for some reason. I have no idea why.
I guess you do.
So Meg DeLacy, thank you so much for hanging out, for showcasing, for just doing your
thing.
Thank you. Brand new song is out right now on all streaming platforms, wherever you get your music. So stream it, download it, add it to your playlist right now. And so Meg, what is next? What's coming up next for you?
Coming up next, well, the show that I talked about earlier, Star Girl, episode 5 is airing tonight at 8 p.m. And you can watch that on the DC platform, which you can subscribe to online, or you could tune in every Tuesday at 8 p.m. On the CW. And then it's kind of a secret, but I'm probably going to be releasing more songs within the next few months. So
I heard.
Hopefully you like them. Yeah.
Little birdie told me. I know it's coming.
Yeah, it's coming. I just want to just blast him out. I just want to give them to the people. I want to share.
All right, Meg. Before we let you go, shout your folks out right now. Say hello to everybody.
Hello, everyone. Thank you guys so much for tuning in and joining this. I love you guys. Thank you for always being in such support. And let's do this. Let's get this music going.
Woo, woo. Boodle fight.
I promise. Pinky swear. Here we go.
All right, Meg, thank you so much. I'll talk to you soon.
I'll talk to you very soon. Thanks, guys. Bye, guys. Mwah. Love y'all.
Get the fresh hits first. Tune in to exclusive Friday at 6 p.m.